Okay, assalamualaikum. Alright, so class, for today, I would like to explain to you the guidelines, okay, on how to answer a problem-based question, okay? So, as for your information, this problem question, okay, problematic question here is very important, okay, especially in your final assessment letter, okay, because you will be given an open book test, okay, and a few questions on the problem based, okay, in regards to problem based question. Alright, so I believe that, okay, I have given to you this question during week 3 after we completed the topic of subsidiary legislation, judicial review on subsidiary legislation. Okay, so according to this question, okay, you have to answer based on ILAC. Okay, so first let me read together the question there. Okay, it is important for you to identify what is parent act, okay, the authority, and then the regulation, the subsidiary legislation in this situation. Okay, based on question 1, under the Welfare of Senior Citizen Act 2016, it teaches the minister is empowered to make regulation pertaining to welfare and protection of senior citizens who have no shelter. In section 5 of the Act, okay, the Act here referred to this, okay, Welfare of Senior Citizen Act 2016, so this is a parent act. It is provided that the minister may make regulations inter alia about matters related to operation, management and supervision of such shelter, which should be provided free of any charge to the affected senior citizens. Consultation must also be made with related bodies before any shelter is to be built. In December 2017, without any prior consultation with related bodies, Rumah Budi was built by the Welfare Ministry. The minister then made the following regulations. Okay, Regulation 2 and Regulation 4 here, known as the subsidiary legislation. Okay, based on Regulation 2 of the Act, annual payment of 100 ringgit must be made by the occupants of the shelter for the purpose of the shelter's maintenance. Regulation 4, any senior citizen who seeks protection at Rumah Budi must only be of the Muslim faith, or else he or she is required to change his or her religion to Islam in order to be given a place at the shelter. Leo, a current occupant of Rumah Budi is a Christian and he is not satisfied with regulations 2 and 4 and would like to challenge their validity. Advise Leo. So now you must advise Leo, okay, whether he may challenge the regulation made by the Ministry of Welfare. Okay. First of all, how you construct how you answer the problem-based question. Okay, as usual, don't forget, okay, we have a formula of ILAC, stand for issue, law, application and conclusion. Alright, so based on this question, what is the issue? How you identify the issue here? Yes, how you identify the issue? Okay, first you are going to look into this regulation 2, regulation 4 and any part of the procedural ultra vires. Okay, first let meet. Okay, the first issue under regulation 2. Okay, so whether how you construct the issue then? Whether regulation 2 may be challenged on the ground of ultra vires of its parent act. Okay, this is your first issue. Okay, whether regulation 2 may be challenged on the ground of ultra vires of its parent act. Why it is ultra vires parent act? Okay, so take a look at section 5 of the act here. Means that, okay, the provision under parent act, provided that the minister may make regulation inter alia about matter related to pressure management supervision such shelter, which should be provided free of any charge. So the section, the provision here stated that minister can make regulation but cannot impose any charge. Okay, so meaning to say that this regulation is ultra vires of its parent act. In other words, it is ultra vires of section 5. Because section 5 tak bagi. Okay, minister not given, the minister is not given the power to impose such fee. However, the minister still to do so. Okay, they still buat regulation 2. So, it may be ultra vires. Okay, so this is your issue. Okay, next, law. Okay, so now I advise you first, untuk law, you have to define subsidiary legislation. Okay, please remember that, okay, you are required to define subsidiary legislation here based on the first issue only. So you hanya masukkan the definitions of subsidiary legislation into the first issue. Okay, and then you discuss the grounds here. Okay, so for the purpose of the explanation, the guidelines I provide you in the simplest form. Okay, later bila you nak explain in your assignments, okay, you want to answer in your final assessment, you have to produce a full, a complete essay. Okay, now the, okay, now the ground here is subsidiary legislation ultra vires parent act. Okay, so you have to explain here. Okay, you need to explain. Okay, I bagi markah nanti for you to explain. Okay, and then okay, siapa you nak guna? For the first issue, you may use the case of anything subsidiary legislation against parent act. Okay, maybe you can choose the case of Datin Azizah Abdul Ghani against Dewan Bandaraya KL. Okay, so just explain the general principle of the case. Okay, what is mean by general principle? You have to highlight that where the case is ultra vires. Give your reason. Okay, now after you explain the case, okay, application. Okay, so for the application, you need to apply the law. Okay, law ni tadi, you have to apply into the current situation, okay, into the present situation. So to how to apply, okay, based on the situation above, okay, based on the situation above, the condition stipulated in the regulation 2 for the payment is ultra vires of the parent at okay, so you can highlight dulu, okay, the condition stipulated in regulation 2 for the payment. Okay, regulation 2 is about the payment of RM100. Must be made by the occupants. So here we refer to, yes, okay, to the payment. Based on the situation above, the condition stipulated in the regulation 2 for the payments of RM100 is ultra vires of the parents. Okay, it is because it's because the condition is beyond the scope of authority granted by the parent. Okay, it is against section 5. Okay, it is against section 5 of the of the welfare of senior citizens. Citizen Act 2016. Okay, then how you conclude? Conclusion. Okay, so you conclude balik lah. Okay, so the regulation 2 may be challenged on the ground of ultra vires of its parent. Okay. Typo here, regulation. Okay. So this is how you answer the first issue. The first issue is related to regulation 2. Okay. So you have the, okay, kita kalikan sikit dia. Okay, you have issue, then you have law, you have a case, important case, the application, okay, conclusion. Okay, application is very simple. Okay, straightforward, you jawab lah, you give your reason. Okay, sebab marks for application, normally I akan bagi 2 marks, okay, for each issue. Alright, so nanti you akan jawab dalam bentuk essay lah, paragraph. Okay, so this is how you answer a problem-based question. Okay, so later we continue with the second issue.